Drop the Beet Farms is an aquaponics consulting and education company, and we create aquaponic systems that use fish to fertilize plants, and the plants purify the water for the fish. Basically, the goal is to bring the outside environment indoors and find a way to grow food sustainably.
It is through aquaponic systems like this that Drop the Beet Farms is bringing this unique farming experience to 10 different school districts across New Jersey, enhancing their STEM curriculum while teaching students about sustainable farming techniques.
It's called the nitrogen cycle, and this is what is a great teaching topic for chemistry and science classes for students. There's actually four different organisms. There's fish involved, there's two types of bacteria that convert the fish waste into fertilizer, and then the plants suck that fertilizer out and it comes back as clean water for the fish in a recirculating ecosystem.
It's gonna regrow every 2 weeks, so I'm just gonna harvest the outside leaves, and then in 2 weeks it's ready for another harvest.
This is the biggest production unit that we've built, and it grows 344 heads of lettuce per month. So that equals about 4,000 heads of lettuce. The good thing about this is it's an intensive crop production plant. So we're growing plants to be 1 month old, and then we're transplanting in here for them to grow for the next month of life. We can grow herbs, we have cilantro in this system, we're growing Swiss chard, bok choy, parsley, mustard greens, watercress we're growing in this system as well. It's a whole spectrum of any type of leafy greens. You could bet you could grow it pretty good in aquaponics. So between all the schools, they're different size systems. Some are larger than others, but it equals out to about 10,000 heads of lettuce that we can produce annually from these systems. The engagement that students have with it, it's irresistible. You have live fish swimming right before your eyes. You have the plants growing very fast. Week by week, you can see them growing. And that opens up the whole realm of when you're actually working with this system, you're trying to figure out how it works. And then you can start delving into chemistry, engineering, different types of sciences that can come from these systems. So once you capture that imagination, they kind of take that ball and they can start getting creative with it. They can start thinking of how they can implement this in their communities. We're just gonna keep on working. We're gonna keep on building systems. We're gonna keep educating students. And the ultimate goal is to connect people with their food, have it be grown locally, sustainably, and be very healthy and nutritious to eat.